Following up for you tonight, after many of you raised questions about why a man who pleaded guilty to sexually assaulting a 4-year-old will likely not see any jail time.
It's part of a plea deal that would give 53-year-old Hector Gonzalez a deferred sentence. News 5's Laura Wilson, she's been covering this case for us. She joins us now with more. Laura.
Well, Gonzalez was initially facing a Class 2 felony and 2 Class 3 felony charges when he was arrested back in August. Yesterday, we learned of a plea deal that reduced his charges to 1 Class 4 felony and a misdemeanor. I sat down with a legal expert today to get a better understanding of why the district attorney's office would offer that deal.
To do that to a child and get off like that, it's amazing.
Valerie Montoya still can't believe the man who sexually assaulted her 4-year-old granddaughter probably won't go to jail for it.
It's not justice. Probation is not justice.
Many News 5 viewers agreed, taking to Facebook Thursday, asking why a plea deal like this even happened.
I know these prosecutors, they take their job seriously. That's why I would assume that there were factors in this case that went beyond what the public's seen and led them to do this.
Criminal defense attorney and former prosecutor James Newby, who is not linked to this case, says a deferred sentence is very unusual for a crime of this nature in El Paso County. Newby says it's likely the DA's office came up with this plea deal only after determining either the evidence or witness testimony might not be enough to get a conviction.
So I'm guessing that when they looked at the case, they felt there's not a high likelihood that we're going to succeed if we go to trial.
The victim's family will have a chance to plead their case at sentencing, where the judge does have the authority to reject the plea deal. Newby says that's an uncommon outcome, but not unheard of.
No judge is just going to say, okay, that's fine, move it along, you know, ignore the feelings of the family. They're going to listen very carefully to the evidence and why the deal is appropriate.
Sentencing is set for May 8th.
And I did reach out to the district attorney's office today asking for an interview or a comment, but my calls were not returned. Rob, Elizabeth, back to you.
Laura, thanks for the follow.